Here it is. The Desert Fox by Harnes. Knife and tool. These are the specs. The blade material is 9CR18MOV. The blade thickness is 5 millimeters, which is pretty thick. The blade HRC is 58 to 60. The blade finish is satin. The overall length is 265 millimeters. And the blade length is 135 millimeters. And the handle material is G10. And the carry system is a leather sheath. So there it is. Okay, it's got these little ear flaps. Okay, there it is. It's got a good looking snap on it. Looks kind of like a shield with the letter H in it for Harnes. Then it has the same thing stamped into the leather there. It's got pretty good looking stitching. It does have a drain hole. Tiny little drain hole there. See if you can see through it at all. Okay, it's got a basic snap. It looks like it's a leather welt. It could be foam, but it feels like it's leather. Like a couple layers of leather. It's not super thin leather, but it's not the world's thickest leather either. And it's got a pretty good size belt loop on it. So you can wear this on your belt. And then it has this side snap here, which I think is so you can carry it like scout carry or side carry, like across your side or your lower back. Although it looks like it's riveted a little high, so I don't know. I guess it might work as long as your belt wasn't too wide. And I do like that type of carry system, but I don't know if I'll be using it for this knife. The sheath does feels a little on the lightweight side, but it does have a lot of features. But you didn't come here to see a sheath, you wanted to see the knife. So here it is. Okay, there it is. Looks like it's got a little oil on it, which it is stainless. Let me see here. It says, Knife and Tool, Harnes. Look at that G10. And there's red liners in there. Lanyard hole. Full tang. And it's got two really nice designer pins holding it in place. It's got some jimping here on the for your thumb. If you pull this way, it's real smooth. If you push, it really grips. It really digs in, so that's pretty good. The blade does go like right there, so I doubt you're gonna reach up over it all. You just have to choke up on it right there. It's got a little finger guard though. Really, really like these handle scales. These were the orange and white. I don't know, just something about it spoke to me, so I grabbed this. That feels like a 90 degree spine. It's a little smooth, but I think it would still strike a fire steel, and this thumb ramp here definitely would, because that is sharp. But you could take a file to it if need be. Let's check out the tip. It doesn't have a super broad tip on it, but it's a good one. The bevel looks okay. Doesn't look too shabby. Try to get the light to hit it just right. And yeah, not too bad. Let me go clean this blade up. Okay, here it is after I polished it up a little bit. You can see it is still a satin steel, but got some of that gunk off the blade. Looks pretty clean and pretty nice. Now this, what was it? The 9CR18 MOV stainless steel is, from what my understanding, is kind of like an AUS8, an AUS8 steel, which is a Japanese steel. They said this one is more of a very high-end Chinese steel. Probably closest related to a 440 stainless, which is used for surgical tools and things like that. And it is a little bit on the hard side, so this might be prone to chipping or nicking. And it's probably not something that you want to do hard tip tests with, you know. Although, look at how thick that is. It is very thick stock. So that should add to its strength. And it all boils down to the heat treatment. If it was heat treated properly, then this is probably a pretty good knife. I really don't know anything about Harnes or Harnes brand. This is the first Harnes knife I've ever purchased. It's called the Desert Fox. And there it tells you the kind of steel it is right on the side. So, I mean, I've seen maybe one or two reviews on this. I'm not sure. But, you know, if it's got a good heat treat, hopefully it's a good steel. Let's get some measurements, though, on this. I realize I already told you the measurements in millimeters, but I don't think in millimeters, so. There we go. You're looking at a big 5 1/4 inch blade to where the cutting edge is, about right there. So that's pretty decent on the blade edge. And you're looking at about almost 10.5 from the whole length, the tip of the blade to the end of the handle there. And the handle scales are probably about, you're looking at 5 inches. So, not too shabby. 5-inch handle, about a little over 5.5-inch blade. It's a nice big knife. It's got some weight to it, but it's not super heavy. Like, you could wear this on your belt. This isn't going to break your back or anything. Feels pretty good in the hand. Feels like these edges are rounded. Let's get this to focus here. But they're not super rounded, so if you were chopping with this, you might get some hot spots. But it feels good. And it's got a little bit of a belly in it, if you can see that. Get that dust off. See that little belly swoop in the middle there? Like a palm swell. That's nice. Fits my hand really good. I like it's got the lanyard hole on it there too, so if you were going to use this for chopping. And I can't say it feels very front heavy. If anything, it feels handle heavy, which means it'll be a very quick knife. You could, more like a combat type knife, in my opinion. Okay, here it is inside the sheath. Goes in pretty good. It wants to stop just outside there, so you have to give it a little extra push to get it, get that handle to go far enough in that this buckles here. And this leather will probably stretch over time, but that is a tight, tight snap. Right now, it took two hands to get it to snap. But it's secure because of that. I mean, this thing is not going anywhere. It's leather, so there's no rattle. And I guess you can wear it sideways or just up and down on your belt. The handle doesn't stick up super high above the belt loop. So that might be fairly comfortable to wear. I don't know what this extra flap of leather is for on the sheath. I mean, it's not really needed, but it looks fine. You could trim it if you wanted to. But it's a good looking sheath. The the orange and white G10 handle scales with the black sheath. I mean, pretty sharp. These are fairly expensive, about $69. You can actually get a Mora Garberg for slightly cheaper. And I would highly recommend the Mora Garberg just because that's a great, great knife in my opinion. But if you're looking for something different with G10 handle scales and a larger blade, you might want to look into Harnes. It seems like the fit and finish is very, very good on these. Like, it doesn't feel cheap at all. And I really like that thumb ramp there. Man, it grabs your thumb like Velcro. It ain't going nowhere. Which is pretty sharp. But let's do a paper cutting test and see if this is pretty sharp. Okay, got a sheet of printer paper here. Got the knife. All I did was clean up the blade, get some oil off of it. But this is how sharp it comes right out of the package. Oh yeah, very sharp. A lot like a Mora. You can get those curve cuts really good. Okay, here's a quick size comparison. This is the Glock 81, and this is the Harnes. Okay, here it is beside a Mora Bushcraft Survival, the heavy duty Mora. You can see he's pretty thick. And the Harnes is a little thicker and a little longer. Okay, my only real gripe so far with the knife is just that when the knife is in, this is hard to buckle. And then when you draw the knife, you run the chance of the blade cutting that. So you got to kind of hold that away yourself. But I like that you can wear it sideways or up and down. If it would have been a little bit thicker sheath like a Condor, I think it would have been nicer, especially for the money. But you're pretty much buying the knife, not the sheath. And it does the job it needs to do, so it's good enough. I mean, it doesn't look bad. I know I'm making it sound like it's an extra chintzy, but it really isn't. It's not that bad of a sheath. And the knife looks great. How the steel will hold up with heavy use, I couldn't say, but in your hand, feels pretty good. And I don't have a whole lot of knives that have G10 handle scales. I think this might be my second or third one. All I can say about them is with my dry hands, they feel slick and slippery to me, but they do have nice texture and they sure do look good. If you had gloves on or a lanyard, it would help a lot for grip. It is the Harnes Knife and Tool Desert Fox. And I think the code for it is HK5006, if you want to find it. They're easy to find on Amazon. You just pick the G10 scales you want. Thought I'd bring that to you today. This is Joe Doomsday signing out. Fürchtet euch nicht.